So guys, welcome. So in this video we are going to paint this greeting card, and greeting card is a very good option to give it to someone, your loved ones or your friends or any occasion. Okay, so I drew this one, and this was a hot press 300 gsm Arches watercolor paper. So this is the my original card which I made for my mother-in-law. So this is a very good card. So what we are going to do, I'm going to generally I'm not going to draw my whenever I make a card, I never make, you know, drawing it, but because I wanted you to see that what is the outline and everything, so I just do very lightly pencil. So this is my brush, and we are not going to work on the layers, we are going to work on varied colors. So I'm using my Scarlet Lake color on that one. So I'm just dropping colors, and this is a dry on wet technique. Remember, I didn't wet my paper at all. So I'm just working on it, this one, and the same color I'm using it. So we just working only on a one layer, one wash, and I'm using my different brush for to drag some color on the above section to make a Venus on the flower, right? So this is the same color I'm using it. You can do that with wet your paper and make it, drop a colors and everything. Now I'm cleaning my this lines with my water brush, and my brush is damp, not so much watery. Remember it, and just I'm cleaning this one. And this is a beautiful card. You can make it so many cards and so many ideas. I'm cleaning continuously on my brush. So, and now this is, I'm making some of my darker red color, okay, on this part of this position. Now I'm using my different brush to drop some yellow on this section. And if you wanted to learn more about my cards, you can follow me on my Facebook or Instagram page about my upcoming workshops and everything. So what I'm doing on it, and you know what I'm taking, and these are all our arts, everything. So you can bring it, that one also. So I'm going to work on that one continuously. Okay. So now I'm using some of my red darker color to make a dark Venus on that one. Okay. So this is very important when you are working. So I'm using different brush to make his Venus, the flower Venus, which one is coming out. So just very light colors, and you can use a different colors also. It's not compulsory that you have the same colors which I'm using. So this is my same red color, just a darker mix, that's it. So I'm softening continuously and making shadows, and I'm not covering my highlights. Remember it, don't cover your highlights on that section. So you can use a blue color, purple color, violet color, whatever you want. There's so many different flowers in this one, and you can make a greeting card with landscape also. There's a lot of landscape good cards. I saw that, and I also made myself. So this is my yellow and little bit of red color. I'm mixing it, mixed color, and I'm just dropping that one for making a leaves. I'm giving like a bouquet, making like a bouquet. So now I'm using my little darker green color, and just little bit of my violet color. So you know, I'm just making darker light leaves, darker leaves, flowers, and everything dark and light color I'm working on it. So some of you can see some of outlines I made it, but for the outer area, for the above and this one area, I'm using my creativity, just my creativity. So you can follow this YouTube as like, or you can make yours to, you know, experiment with yours, everyone. So this was my green and yellow, and this was is only my green color, And now I am painting like negative painting. So, like leaves coming out or the branches and everything coming out like that. So I'm making darker and light and darker and light color. So this is my little bit of blue. I'm just dropping that on that section. So this is like negative painting. I'm working on it. So I'm just, painting around the subject and flowers and everything. So look at that, how beautifully it is coming out. And this is very good exercise for us and very good gift you can give to your loved ones or your friends or your family. So, this was a very good gift. You can calligraphy with this is my blue color. I'm dropping that on that section. So this is a good gift, good exercise, and everything is very perfect when you make it. And you can do calligraphy on. You can wrote "Get well soon," "Thank you," "Happy anniversary," "Happy birthday," "Happy graduation," whatever you want. My own. So this is my wallet color. I'm dropping on that section. On that section, I'm dropping it. And some of on this section here, I'm dropping because I wanted to make a rhythm on that. So that's why. I'm working continuously and I'm looking my coming out, going and further and through and everything I'm working on that one. And when you sorry, when you if it's a helpful this video, if this video is helpful for you, you can tag me on your final artwork with my on my social media account, which was in comment section, my Facebook and my Instagram account, and this is my yellow. So you can tag me on that one also. I will be really appreciate with you all this one. So this is my green and yellow. You can see that how I'm working on this one. So this was this very 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 good idea. And this was a suggestion one of my viewers who wanted to give me a demo of that greeting cards. And so you can also give me some your suggestion that what you wanted me to paint on your my next YouTube tutorial. So in comment section or you can email me. So there's a lot of options. So this is my green and my yellow and little bit touch of my blue. And this is only my green, which I weighed the vanish. So you can see that I'm on that section. I didn't draw anything. I just making, through my. Let's say. So this is my green and blue. Everything. And this is my small leaves I'm making on this one. I'm painting this one like. So now we are going to paint our this section here and same blue and green, and this one is ultramarine blue and violet color. I'm using it and I'm dropping the colors and I'm making shaping like it's a flower and something like that. So remember it, it's an important. And if you not comfortable to creating something like that, you can follow your reference picture. There's a lot of good reference picture on the Google, which was not copyright. You can use it. There is not, and you can sell it also. So don't worry about that. There's a lot of good pictures on Shutterstock and everything. So you can follow that one. So this is my wallet color I dropped on that section. You can see that how beautiful is coming out. And you can paint this one with cold press paper also, but I think the flowers and everything is very good coming out on hot press paper. So you can use a cold press paper. It's not any, So this is my blue and darker blue. I'm now looking that I'm using a negative painting, so and it's like a flower here, right? So this is my main flower. We are working on that main flower over. So this is my violet and my cadmium red color. So I'm just mix the both colors and I put it in that, and this is my only red color outer side, and I'm just soften the edges on my color section. Look at that. So this is, and this is the that. And now I put that. So you can see what I did. First I put my watercolor pigment and then I soften it and then I use my light and then I put my darker on that section. This is my violet color I using, and that section I use my violet and red mix. And I'm continuously, when I soften edges with color, I continuously cleaning my brush. And use your damp brush always. Remember it. So this is my blue. And it's coming out really beautifully. Look at that. So this is the kind of shadow, light to blue, dark to light, you have to follow when you make some of very good painting. So it's coming out very beautifully. I'm saying again and again this thing. Don't worry about that. So this is my yellow and red mixture. To one side I put red and second side I put yellow color, and I drag both of colors to make a good flower. So I already told you, I already said it, this thing that you can use a different color also, whichever your favorite color series. But remember, you have to follow the whole color on, not only the one section, you have to follow the color the whole painting, whole section, whole card. So you can see what I'm doing here. This is very simple. Simple, not simple. Sorry, simple. It's very simple. So this is my pinkish color, and it's called Scarlet Lake and Opera Rose. There are a lot of pink colors coming out in the market and different brands, and you can experiment with them also. And I think when I make a cards, I don't have to buy very highly or very costly colors. You can use very cheap brand on also that. I'm not saying cheap brand, but yeah, not so much costly brand. That was a good word. So this is my blue color, and I'm making it with something veins and everything, and I'm putting some green color on that one. So you can see how beautiful it's coming out, and I'm saying again. So because I like this one, so this is my violet and my blue color. So because I wanted to make a tuning with that main flower, that's why I put it there. I think this was looking very alone on that one. So now it's coming out through. So and now you can see on when you are making this kind of painting, you don't have to make a good drawing skill. You don't need a good drawing skill. You can make your own with your you can use landscape. I already told you the countryside scene or boat scene or beach scene, or make a landscape with something birds. I'm going to show you in my next lesson. If you wanted to see that, you can give me a comment section, then I will make video. So there it is. I'm just working on it and it's coming out. It's really looking beautiful. You can calligraphy with, write with the something, whatever you want, like thank you, get well soon, happy anniversary, happy birthday, etc. Happy Christmas, happy Diwali, whatever you like. So you can do that also with yourself. And there's a lot of calligraphy things coming out, the stencil thing on the art store center. The Michaels is giving so much good stencil things. You can use that one also. And you can sell out these kind of cards by yourself. This was very easily. And you can stick with your this sheet on your cards, which was available on that Blick Art Store, Hobby Lobby, the lots of art stores. So that was is done, and seriously, it's looking beautiful, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm just giving some of color. So I think that was completely, and I'm just dropping some color on that section. So this was a good idea to make something good to for your loved ones. So hope you're going to like this one, and I think this was very good. So this is complete. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Hope you're going to like this one and you're going to try that one. And don't forget, when you complete this artwork, to tag me on your Facebook or social media account and follow me on my Facebook and social media account. This was all in my comment section. Also, because it's coming out for my watercolor adventure and Wonder World, you can follow me on that one. You can know about more than. And I will be appreciate if you share this video with your friends and whoever you know that. So I will be really appreciate about that one. So hope and thank you very much for watching this my channel, and subscribe my channel. And if you didn't subscribe it, please subscribe my YouTube channel, because your love and support give me so much to do more, so much to give me new ideas to give it to you. And one more thing I'm going to say I want to share with you. I started my Skillshare online school, and this will be coming out on next month or maybe 28th Feb. I think that was not a fixed date, but yeah, I will give you update. And so if you are on the Skillshare, follow me on that Skillshare lesson. And if you didn't know what is a Skillshare, you can go on the Google and find out what is a Skillshare. This is a very, very, very on the budget online school. You can follow a lot of artists there, a lot of illustration, everything. And I'm going to give you a video lesson on that Skillshare lesson soon. I will be share my link, the Skillshare link. I'm going to share with you my next video. So be prepared about that one also. And that was a fun thing. And I like Skillshare because I thought there's so many artists who wanted to learn watercolor painting, but because of cost and lot of things, home life things, we can't afford that one. So that was a very, very, very good. If you follow that one, I'm going to give you a lot of good lessons on that one also, that Skillshare online school also. So don't forget it, and I hope I'm going to see you in my next lesson. And I'm going to say again, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, and don't forget to follow my Facebook and Instagram for know more about my upcoming watercolor workshop and my watercolor wonderland and everything. Thank you guys. My name is Nibhu Manish, and watching my YouTube channel. Thank you guys. Bye-bye. I'm going to see you in my next lesson.